actually some questions that will help you to examine your motives. Do you have the right motives or not? For example, are you interested in this service because there are some unresolved issues in your life? And here actually, you need, before serving the lost sheep, you need actually to deal with this unresolved issues. For example, if you yourself were exposed to abuse in childhood, and you have some anger toward your the abuser, whether a parent or a relative or whatever, and there is bitterness in your heart toward this, and be lack of forgiveness, and because of this, you decided to go and help the abused children who strayed away from God and from the church because of their abuse. Then actually, in order to be successful in your ministry, you need first to deal with your unresolved issues. Because if you don't deal with them, then you will actually give them your anger, give them your bitterness, and you'll make them angry like you and bitter like you. That's why it is very important, if the motive behind serving in this area, because I myself went through some negative experience, then I need actually to deal with these unresolved issues, if there is any. But if you dealt with them, then you are ready after being trained to serve in this area, the ministry of the lost sheep. The second point, do you have the spiritual maturity that qualify you to lead the lost sheep back to Christ? For example, if you don't know how to swim, you cannot actually help a person who is drowning. And that's why maybe you noticed this convention or this retreat, we did not announce it publicly, but it was by invitation. And we asked the priests in every church and Sunday school coordinator to nominate some servants in order to attend this retreat. Because we expect that you yourself should be spiritually mature before going and serving others. As St. Paul said in Galatians chapter 6, verse 1, if somebody is taken in trespass, you who are spiritual, save this person with gentleness and meekness. So who actually should serve in this ministry? People who are spiritually mature. Spiritually mature doesn't mean sinless, but spiritually mature, as St. Paul explained it in Hebrews chapter 5, be able to discern between right and wrong. Be able to discern, because they have their senses trained, they can discern between right and wrong. The following question, am I ready to take the responsibility and be compassionate and have integrity, be transparent, being not judgmental, even if the lost sheep attacked me or triggered me to anger? Sometimes the lost sheep, when you talk to him, he may get angry at you, he may curse you, he may lose his temper, you know, he will attack you. Are you ready to accept this or not? St. Paul said, we were cursed, but we blessed. So, if I'm not ready to take this for Christ, and to carry this cross, then I'm not ready for this ministry. Maybe another ministry in the church. But many times, dealing with the lost sheep is a challenge. And some of them, because of all the circumstances went through, they are difficult. And they may give you a hard time. They may try to challenge your authority. They may try to manipulate you. Manipulate you. So you need to be mature enough to take the responsibility, to be compassionate with their weakness without judging them. The moment you start judging them, they are bad or evil, the moment you are disqualified to serve them. A very important characteristic of the servant to be non-judgmental, to understand sin as illness, as a disease, need to be treated, not to be condemned. Sin is a disease, needs to be treated, not to be condemned. Another question, am I ready to be exposed to psychological and emotional pressure that many times the servant of the lost sheep are exposed to? Dealing with them actually is very draining. Sometimes discussion are very, very draining. And after 1 hour or 2 hour, you feel exhausted. You feel like you need just to disconnect, just to relax a little bit. And that's why these servants need like support group within each other. They say, for almost 80 hours with the lost sheep, 2 weeks, if I speak about work for 1 hour a week, for every 2 weeks actually, you need 2 hours of like spiritual support group, or 1 hour per week. To connect together, to pray together, to get support from one another. And this is the importance of the servant meeting for the lost sheep servants. They should actually meet weekly basis just to get support from each other, to pray together, to talk together, to study the Bible together. This actually will support them, because in this ministry, you will be exposed to emotional and psychological. Emotional, they will put a huge guilt trip on you, and they will blame you for everything. They blame you when you are not blamed, and how to deal with this. So that's, I'm not scaring you, but I'm trying to make you ready and to know what to expect. What about those whom I don't feel comfortable around them? Maybe there are some tension between our families and their family. For example, if there is a family that your family have an issue with them, and then their son is one of the lost sheep, are you willing to go and help him with neutrality, with no package in your heart, with no putting the other family in shame? Here is your son. So do you have this integrity inside you to be able to help others even when you don't feel comfortable? What about if his father or his mother cursed you? Are you willing still to have this love and compassion and continue to serve him or not? Again, the most important element in this ministry is love. You need to love them unconditionally. Unconditionally. There is no condition to love these people. Another question. Do I understand the fact, the truth, the biblical truth, that unfortunately not every lost sheep will return back to God through the ministry of the lost sheep? It's a fact. If you don't understand this, you will fall in despair. And you will feel down, you feel depressed, because there is no fruit. Many of the servants, or us as clergy, we like the ministry that is fruitful. You know, when you work with, compliant, obedient, godly youth, and when you call for a meeting, you'll find them around you. You know, this ministry is rewarding because you see fruit every day. But the ministry of the lost sheep, you may serve for years and you don't see any fruit. Are you willing to continue without losing your motivation to continue in this ministry? The Lord Jesus Christ served and served and served and served Judas. But unfortunately, Judas, as a lost sheep, did not return. He served faithfully the scribes and the Pharisees and the religious leaders. And unfortunately, many of them did not repent and return back. St. Paul, one of his companions and disciples, Demas, left him. And we don't know whether he returned or not. And St. Paul said, those whom I remember them crying. So he was crying when he remembered them. It is unfortunately a fact that not every lost sheep we serve, they will return. So the focus here is not on the fruit. The focus on your faithfulness in the service. You need to be faithful and wise in your service. But actually, if you are looking for the fruit, you will be discouraged. Most of the addiction center, the percentage of relapse exceed 70%. So if they are evaluating themselves based on the fruit, they will get discouraged. And they may start to question themselves whether what we are doing is right or wrong. But again, if my focus on the faithfulness and the wisdom, not on the fruit. Another question, am I ready to go through all the training, all the study, all the supervision that I need to go through in order to be equipped for this ministry or not? For example, youth before applying to medical school, they ask themselves this question, am I ready to go through all these years of study and then residency and, you know, or not? Again, in the same way, training here is long, supervision, study. I'm willing to take this seriously in order to be a servant for the lost sheep or not. And the last question is, am I willing for like continuing education? Always I study and read to develop the skills that God gave me, to develop the talent that God gave me, whether in counseling, whether in teaching, whether in how to approach the lost sheep, etc. So these questions actually are very important to ask ourselves. Again, this question, the purpose of it, not to discourage you from this ministry, rather to take it seriously, to take it seriously. You know, it's not just a conference you attend and that's it. No, the training actually is more than a conference or a retreat you attend.